Good morning, students. Today we are going to start a new chapter, and the name of the chapter is India's Landforms. This is a chapter from your geography section, and it's a very important chapter. So I want all of you to read this chapter very carefully, line by line, so that you can understand it very properly. So let us begin. Follow your books. India is a big and beautiful country. It has a variety of landforms, mountains, valleys, plains, plateaus, and deserts. The map here shows India's main landforms and water bodies. As you can see, the southern part of India is surrounded by water on three sides. It is a peninsula. A peninsula is a piece of land almost surrounded by water. India has oceans and seas to the east, west, and south. Its islands lie in the sea on the east and west. Based on its landforms, India's land may be divided into six broad regions. The northern mountains, the northern plains, the Thar Desert, the peninsular plateau, the coastal plains, and the islands. So, in this part, you can see that this chapter, we are talking about the various landforms that we see around us. So, what are the variety of landforms that we see? They are the mountains, valleys, plains, plateaus, and deserts. These are some of the landforms that we can see all over the world, right? But we are talking about a map here. You have this map in your book. Okay, so this map shows you India and the various landforms that we can find in this country. So you see, this map is divided into various colors. These colors show us the various landforms that we can find in the different parts of the country. Along with that, you can see that there are two seas and one ocean. Okay, we have the Arabian Sea, we have the Bay of Bengal, and we have the Indian Ocean. So you see that the country of India has water on most of the side. But this part, the northern part, does not have water. This part has land. So, a landform which has water on almost all of the sides is called a peninsula. This structure is called a peninsula. Why? This part is a peninsula. Why? Because it has water on almost all of the sides, but not on all the sides. Here you see you have the Andaman and Nicobar Islands, you have the Lakshadweep Islands. What is the basic difference between an island and a peninsula? An island has water on all sides. You see Andaman and Nicobar Islands, They are not connected to the mainland of India. Okay, they are separate from it. They are a part of India, but they are separate. They are covered by water on all sides. They are surrounded by water on all sides. But not so in the case of the Indian mainland. Our country, the main country has land surrounding its northern sides. We have Pakistan, we have China, Nepal, okay, Bangladesh. We have these countries that surround our northern side. So this part of the country is called a peninsula. So what is being said here is the southern part of India is surrounded by water on three sides. It is a peninsula. What is a peninsula? A peninsula is a piece of land almost surrounded by water. So, if you are asked what is a peninsula, this is going to be your answer. Okay? A piece of land surrounded by water on almost all sides is known as a peninsula. India has oceans and seas to the east, west, and south. Okay? So, you have the Arabian Sea, the Bay of Bengal, and the Indian Ocean. Based on its landforms, India may be divided into six broad regions. So here we saw the variety of landforms that prevail in our world, right? So, according to these various landforms, we can divide India into six broad regions. What are these regions? They are the Northern Mountains, the Northern Plains, the Thar Desert, the Peninsular Plateau, the Coastal Plains, and the Islands. So, these are the six regions that we are going to read about in this chapter. This chapter concerns about these six regions that are found in India. In this video, I will be discussing the Northern Mountains. So, let's move on to that part. This is the same map, the previous map, the map given in your book. This is the same map. I have just zoomed it out so that you can get a clearer picture. You see this map that is given in your book. Here, this section. This is the Northern Mountain regions. Okay, I have zoomed it here so that you can see it clearly. Northern and Eastern Mountain regions. This grayish part. Okay, so this grayish part, this shows us the mountain regions. So let us see what the Northern Mountains have. A number of high mountain ranges form the northern boundary of India. The northernmost of these is the Karakoram Range. To its south is the Himalaya. The Himalaya is made up of three main ranges. From north to south, they are the Great Himalaya, the Lesser Himalaya, and the Outer Himalaya. The Great Himalaya has some of the world's highest peaks. Among these are Mount Everest, Nepal, the highest peak in the world, and Kanchenjunga, India, the third highest. So you see, first and foremost, they are talking about the Karakoram ranges. Coming back to the map again, if you see here, to the extreme north of India, there are the Karakoram ranges. Towards the south of the Karakoram ranges, okay, these mountain ranges, they are known as the Himalayan ranges. Okay, so the Himalayan ranges are divided into three parts. As you can see here, I have given a list here of the three parts. Okay, so the northernmost part, that means this part, northernmost, they are the Greater Himalayas, which are also known as the Himadri. Then you have the Lesser Himalayas, which is the range below the Greater Himalayas. They are also known as the Lesser Himalayas, Middle Himalaya, or Himachal. And then you have the southernmost, okay, the Outer Himalaya or Shivalik ranges. So these are the few names that are used to describe the three separate parallel ranges of the Himalayas. Okay, so these three ranges are parallel to each other. What is a parallel line? You have read in, you have studied about parallel lines in maths, right? A line, then again one line. Two lines, two straight lines which do not meet at any point are called parallel lines, right? So you see these Himalayan ranges, these three separate ranges are also parallel to each other. Okay, they run from this side to this side and they are parallel to each other. So, these are the Himalayan ranges, and the three of the ranges are the Great Himalayas, the Lesser Himalayas, and the Outer Himalayas. In these three separate ranges, there are a number of peaks. Among them, the highest peak in the world, which is Mount Everest, is found in the Himalayan ranges. Okay, but the highest peak, Mount Everest, is not located in India. It is located in Nepal. And the third highest peak, which is Kanchenjunga, is located in India. So, two famous peaks, the highest and the third highest, both of them are located in the Himalayan mountain ranges. The peaks of the high mountains are covered with snow. Many of them have glaciers moving down their slopes. A glacier is a very large mass of ice that moves slowly down a slope. As glaciers move to the lower, warmer parts of a mountain, they melt. The resulting water often forms rivers. The Ganga rises from a glacier called Gangotri and the Yamuna rises from a glacier called Yamunotri. So you see, in this part, we are talking about glaciers. What are glaciers? Glaciers are very large mass of ice that moves slowly down a slope. See this picture here. In this picture, you see this part. Okay. What do you see? You see lots of ice and snow, right? So, glaciers are big, huge structures. Okay. About the size of a building or even bigger. They can be even bigger than the size of a building. Okay. So, these glaciers, they are huge masses of ice. And what do they do is, as the mountains are steep. Okay. Mountains are sloping downwards, right? They are neither flat nor straight like this. They are sloping downwards. So if glaciers are formed here, they come slowly downwards, right? So as they are coming downwards, what happens is they slowly melt. Why do they melt? Remember the chapter about weather and climate we had read? In that chapter, we had seen that as we climb higher up towards the top of the mountain, the temperature is lower, right? So it is cold at the top of the mountain. But as we come down towards the plain surface, it gets hotter, right? So at the top of the mountain, you see in this picture also, there is so much ice and snow. But where we live, do we get snow? We don't get snow. Why? Because it is warmer. So as these glaciers, they move downwards, okay, they start to melt. And what happens is, when they melt, they form rivers. And some examples are the Ganga River and the Yamuna River. And the glacier which gives rise to the river Ganga is called Gangotri. And Yamuna rises from the Yamunotri glacier. So if you are asked that, give an example of a glacier, okay, what are you going to say? You're going to say Gangotri is a glacier or Yamunotri is a glacier. Okay. So the names of, if you ask two names of two glaciers, you can say Gangotri and Yamunotri. They are two glaciers, right? And if you ask examples of rivers which rise from the glaciers, you can say Ganga rises from the Gangotri glacier, Yamuna rises from the Yamunotri glacier. So, this is about the glaciers that are found in the northern mountain regions. Now, let's move on to the next part. There are many beautiful valleys in the Himalaya. The Kashmir Valley is one of them. Another is Dehradun. Dun means valley. The mountains have many hill stations too, like Shimla, Nainital, Mussoorie and Darjeeling. So now we are talking about valleys. What are valleys? See, I'm drawing a rough sketch for you. Suppose these are two mountains. Okay, this is the peak of a mountain. And this is the peak of a mountain. Okay, this portion that is forming the V, this portion is a valley. And this valley portion is not very cold like the peaks of the mountain and not very hot like the plain regions we live in. Okay, they have a very suitable moderate type of temperature. During the winter it is hot, but during the summer the temperature is somewhat pleasant. So there we have the famous Kashmir Valley and Dehradun. Okay, the Dehra Valley. Dun itself means valley. So you don't say Dehradun Valley, it's Dehradun. The mountains have hill stations. Some very famous places we like to visit. They are Shimla, Nainital, Mussoorie and Darjeeling. So these are the few hill stations we go to visit during the summer seasons, right? Now let's talk about the life in the mountains. It is difficult to build roads, railways and towns in the mountains. So fewer people live here. The cold climate is good for growing fruits such as apples, pears and walnuts. Tea is grown in the eastern Himalaya. Herding animals Tourism and making handicrafts such as carpets and woolen things are the other ways of earning a living. So you see, the life in the mountains is a bit difficult. Why it is difficult? Because you see, it is difficult to build roads, railways or towns. Why? Because the surface is not smooth. Mountains are rough. So that is why very few people live there. And it is also very cold up in the mountains. And this cold also bothers people. But the cold climate is good for growing fruits like apples, pears and walnuts. And it is also good for growing tea in the eastern Himalayas. Herding animals, tourism and making handicrafts such as carpets and woolen things are other ways of earning a living. So what do people do there? People also herd animals, and tourism is a very flourishing industry. Why? Because when we go to visit these places, we need places to stay, we need food to eat, right? So the people who live there provide us places to live in or food to eat. There are hotels, there are restaurants. Okay, so that is why tourism is also a way the people earn their living. And making of handicrafts. This is very famous in the mountain regions. Carpets, they make carpets and woolen clothes. They are very good at it. And this is the way they earn their living. So this part is up till here. It's about the Himalayan regions. Okay. So, this is the end of the Himalayan region part, the northern mountain parts. The next part deals with the northern plains. We'll be talking about it in a different video. So, that's all for this video. Thank you and bye-bye.